Hello and good day, collective. We are going to get to a collective twin flame reading because the individual reads are just too much with the upload and whatnot. Got some music behind me. Enjoy it, you know. I hope it doesn't become too much, but you know, we're working with what we got here. So, for those of you that don't know, I'm an Aquarian and I channel. I read intuitively. And we are just going to listen in and see what the spirits have to say to me today. So be patient with me, especially if I'm, you know, dragging one card over here or there, you know, I'm just decoding. So let's see, spirits, which deck are we starting with? Okay. This is my smallest deck. Let's see what's good. Still going. Okay. And I'm going to tell a story yet. No. Okay. Bear with me. What I do see is the Five of Wands on your person's side. And it looks like they're ready to put the conflict and fighting down. What's that at? Okay. Yeah. They're saying that you're presently, you're just in the midst of your journey. Your person has restrictions on you. And your journey, so I don't know, maybe the spirits are blocking them from you. We'll get more into that. Who's in it? Jesus. Yeah. Okay, so right now you're coming in like the King of Swords, so you're really thinking with your mind, you know, your intellect. You're probably not got too much of your heart in there. Maybe your person, you know, ripped that apart. I don't know. You had to bring the sword out. I don't know. But, you know, the King of Swords, it's not like he's off with your head, you know, like the Queen. So it looks like you're sitting there, yeah, in your journey like a King of Swords. But the person who's coming in like this here, and is that currently? Is that currently? Some of you, okay, so what I'm showing here on your side, this is interesting. One moment. I'm getting confused, brother. Who's this page? Oh, okay, the person is the page. Okay. Well, looks like they're getting a message here from somewhere. I'm guessing the spirits. It's about you, is what that's what it is. It's about you. What that is, oh, and your journey. That they're being told to have strength, so they're having to pull their strength together. With the restrictions, there it is. Okay, got it. All right, let's keep this going here real quick. And I'll clarify that, back it up a bit just to make sure I understood that correctly. That took a minute. All right, where are we at with this? And this? What about it? So there's some expansion going on in the middle of your journey. There's some cycle that you're in. It's expanding. That's great. Oh, and it's intense. Okay. Oh, my hand is in shit. I wonder if some money's about to come in, you know, for you. I'm feeling, you know, good. I'm feeling happy. Oh, okay. Whatever is going on, your person is getting, there's restriction on what, though? Maybe they'd be coming in real intense with you because they have restrictions. So maybe, they're putting this down, but it is on its side. So maybe they're not quite over their little issues, you know, that are probably unwarranted. Where else are we going here? Man. Okay, who's coming in like that? So interesting. It's like both of your energies are like in, like, yeah, the Knight of Wands, in and out, in and out. They're finding, but this is to come. Intensity. So maybe they showing up back up in your life and you are coming in like a knight, like, you know, it's feeling kind of good, but do I or don't I? Where does this rest, though, spirit? It rests on your side, though. It's them coming into your life intensely. Got Scorpio right here. What that represents is intense. And so they're telling me they're coming in. Okay, that's interesting. Alright, where are we going with this? So Eight of Swords. You know, they're flipping this over right there with the Five of Wands. Like, they're putting some things to rest. Your person is, it seems like they're growing, dude. They just got a tower. Alright, well, let's what's up with this? Where's this at? So they're holding on while you dropped the burdens I'm showing here with the Ten of Wands and this Four of Pentacles. Yeah. Okay, who size is this tower on? Is it big or small? Which way did we want this? Okay, so it's like almost like they might have two towers coming in here, is what it seems like. Let's clarify that. Where is this at? Oh. Wow, okay. Wow, it's all over the board. A lot of these energies are bouncing back and forth. So I wonder if you guys are coming into alignment, but not quite, because I haven't seen anything in the unified section yet. But the tower on your side is this lovers. But they put it over here, they're holding on to you. Okay, they're letting you know that they are holding on to you. There's gonna be expansion. Wow. The union is gonna have a tower here soon. Where is this going? Oh, for you. They have the Ten of Pentacles. Oh man, and everything's just, it keeps showing me there's a cycle going on. Okay, where? How do you want this space? How do we want it? Oh, on their side. So for them, the tower is this Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Now that's when everything's great. You got wealth, even relationships are doing well. So your pocket's doing great, your relationships are doing great. With, you know, romance and community, family. What they're showing to me though is for them it's not, but for you it is. Okay, so it's like this tower is going on. Positive for you, not so positive for them. And they're sitting over here with this, and this represents sharing, okay? And they're holding on, they're not sharing. They themselves are restricting themselves from sharing. I don't know if that's, I know in my own personal situation, some truth and some clarity, things have been unbalanced. Where are we going here? Now something that they're not coming in as a fair partner. They are coming in like this page while you're coming in like this King of Swords. That's interesting. Where are we going? Come over to Healing with the Angels. Yeah, and see, the Ten of Wands, you know, went from your side to like you just, and dropped it off on their side. Like you just dropped them and that. And they left it face up like this. So it seems like, you know, they might be coming to a completion, but they haven't dropped some burden yet. Oh, they're telling me they haven't surrendered and released. So I'll ask in a minute, see if we can get more clarification on what that is. Well, surrender and release the burdens, what burden that might be. Okay, whose side does this rest on? So the Knight of Wands, they're saying, is in a place that either they are meditating about all this or they need to. In order to drop the burdens here. Yeah, they're telling your person that they need to meditate. Where are we going? Okay. So yeah, it seems like they're recommending you to be stepping out in nature if you aren't already. A lot that you can learn out in nature. You know, the spirit speak to us in so many ways. If you just even listen to the wind, or you feel a gust of wind come in with a thought, or you're in conversation with some people and the wind is quite still that day, but you just feel this big old gust. Take a look around you, because I've done that before, and there's barriers that made no sense why some wind could just rush all out in like that. You know, pay attention to those signs. Go out in nature and see what they have to say to you. They're saying your union needs that. Okay. Oh, wow. Whoa. And where is this going? on your side. I can't lie. Wow, see what I'm saying? They're hitting our guardian angel over here on your person's side. Whose side does it rest on? Yeah, so your person's gonna find, they're gonna have assistance from a guardian angel while they meditate. You see this person? Look how sad. Like, they are like stressed, you know? Look at them. They look up and look around at the nature. They'll see that there's answers all around them. Oh, this is looking good. Where's this one going? Yeah, they're telling them miracles. Oh, it's on both of your sides. So the guardian angels are going to show them a miracle. On your side, it's hitting your Ten of Pentacles. That's in upright. And it's resting on your side. So I don't know. You're looking pretty good. They just said answered prayer on top of the miracles. Answered prayer for your person with the guardian angel. But they rested answered prayer on your side. And where, okay, man, this is all happening pretty soon here. The answered prayer seems a little more in the near distant future. The miracles, when they kicking in here for? They're coming pretty soon. The signs, when they coming? I mean, they're forever going, but they're saying with this miracle, look for the sign. So there's probably gonna be some answer within nature or just around you, or you're gonna find you're gonna have something answered that you've been wondering about. You're gonna either, you could have a thought like, dang, you know, should I watch out for this person? I'm not so sure. I mean, you should listen to your intuition anyway, but then you might hear an alarm go off like, that's the kind of signs you're talking about. All right, guardian angel for what? This intensity that's coming up. Oh, your person's going through it. They're really going through it. All right. But rest assured, they're okay. So you need to keep on with whatever you're doing. Keep focusing on you. The more you focus on you, the more space they have to figure their own shit out. Okay? And you to call in the match that's ready for you. Or matches, I don't know. Shoot, I'm not hating on, you know, Kali, you know. But I will say this, you guys. The reason why a union is sacred to me, who I give my body to, or share my body with, is because you don't know what energies are attached to them. So you really want to trust as much as you best can your intuition with them. And what you are seeing, don't ignore the signs, because what they go out into the world, it doesn't even have to be romantically. They bring that home to you, and then they bring it into your bed. And the energy exchange that you guys make, that you intertwine, okay? Souls, unless you just, you know, there for a quickie, I guess. I mean, so can still be connected and have a cookie, but you know what I'm saying. You gotta be aware of who the people in your life have in their life, because they bring those energies back around you. And if you're not prepared, that stuff could really mess up your world. That could mess up your health, you know. It could cause setbacks, you know. And so this twin flame union, I don't think it's meant to be sleeping with X, Y, and Z. I just don't, because it's already enough to balance your two energies together. Imagine trying to balance unhealed people, okay, that have attached themselves and their spirit and their whatever is attached to them to your person. I mean, just think about that. All right, where are we going, spirit? All right, just think about that. It's real out here. Yeah, your person's side. Five of Swords. What now? It's about some burden. I don't know. Where are we at? Oh, you. Oh, walking away from you. They are going through it. And then how do we want this? Oh, face down, signs. Guess what you have coming? This is what you have coming. I can't make it up. But they had it face down on the miracles and the signs, meaning this is not yet arrived, but it's coming. Look at that. Love is, that's two people seeing eye to eye. You have an attraction to somebody, but this is something that's happening. This is something that's in the works. That's why you're telling to watch the signs. Miracle. Finally, love is on its way to you. Windows closing for your twin flame. They don't get it together. What about it? Yep. Okay. Wow. So what I see here is you have unbound yourself. They have not. You are seeing this version, not this person in the mirror who's bound by this Eight of Swords all in their head, and it's resting on their side. So good job. You guys are learning to fight through this. I know it's been tough. Way to hang in there. Where's Guardian Angel is helping. Oh, wow. Yo, this, you guys can see what I see. So they hit the Guardian Angel side with this Ace of Cups, this big old cup of love. So that's on your person side, okay? So it looks like, then they hit the Lovers, then they hit the Intensity Scorpio sign, and the Knight of Wands. So I don't know what happened, but here in the near future, this is what they're coming in with, not the Page. That's why the Page is still resting on their side, I gather. But you also, they might reach out, and you also reach back. That's what I feel like. Or you might be reaching out before. If I were really to say how I feel when I read this, it was y'all reaching out. But I can't imagine that happening for the collective, because I'm sure we've all been reaching out. We have all been biting our tongues and giving them the space and letting them have their little tantrums or their fits, you know, and whatnot, and then extending our love. So, but it's all right. It's okay. You feel moved to provide another message, and you feel moved to provide another message. One way or another. In the union. Is this in the union? Okay, it landed in the union. It is in the union. Six of Swords. But look at that, though. What's interesting, I see why they landed it in the union, because in that boat, there's one person. Six of Swords is, you know, moving on to calmer waters. Now, that could be your mental space. That could also be literally moving, traveling, crossing seas, even to move on to a better situation, you know. So the union itself is, and they just flipped over the Lovers. I didn't even realize what was there, and my hand just went through. This is what I talk about, following their energy. They're hitting this Lovers and hitting this Ace of Cups. So that's where it's all going. What? Oh, wait, who's got this? Yes. So once they surrender and release, they are going to have a completion with this World card. But okay, what were you doing, Spirit? You put it over here. Oh, okay, so they're putting it in reverse on your side, collective, which I'm guessing you guys have done the work, and you're not quite sure whether or not it's time to, you know, completely end this contract and tear it up and be done with it. You don't even do like a ritual or something to actually dispose of it and disconnect from them. But I'm sure a lot of you just have that loyal heart, not only to the connection, but to your soul contract to come down here and fix whatever this is. So yeah, where does this rest? On their side. So once they surrender and release, they're gonna have that completion come in. Oh, and then it pushes it into the Lovers, the answered prayer, the miracles. Whoa, this is crazy. They have to unbind themselves. They say, okay, what else here? All right, this actually feels like a really, even though there's so much in their thoughts, wow, okay, dang, okay, say that again on their side. You don't see this coming. You don't see the Ten of Pentacles coming, is what they told me just now. But on their side, your person is stepping into High Priestess mode. They are going within, holding that next to this Eight of Swords. And they're on their side, the way they're laying them down. They're going within, they're doing the work. What? Anything else? All right. How are you? Good to see you. I had to stop and say hi to a friend. Okay, wow. Oh, when they said they're fearless about it, it's a Sagittarius energy about you. They're fearless about you. What? Oh, Lord have mercy. They said ahead. Ahead what? Lovers, ahead. Wow. And they're hitting this Ace of Cups again, talking about ahead. Ahead. Wow. Is that why I feel so good? Oh, some of you might be dating a Virgo here. This is for someone that's steadfast, but they put it in reverse. So I'm thinking they want me to throw out there. Some of you, they put it on the Lover's card. So when it's in reverse, I feel more often than not, they want me to notice the sign versus the key word for it. So some of you out here are probably dealing with the Virgo, okay? So that's special information for you. I'm dealing with a Virgo. Well, I'm not. It's like the relationship that's not a relationship. It's fucking crazy. But I feel for the most part, I've released it. Like, I've done everything that I could do. I've said everything that I could say, man. It's like she got to step up to the plate. You know, I am welcoming in a new love, steadfast, and on the Virgo, and the love says persevere. Wow, what else? Okay, what is that? To what? Where do you want this? Oh, got it. Well, let me grab it. Okay, got it. So, okay, ahead. This means release, and they're tapping their surrender and release card and this ahead sign. Okay, we'll take it. Where does this rest? Yeah, okay. Where to? Anything else here? Back to healing with the angels. Wait, does this say that we need... Okay, I was like, wait, does this mean that... Look, I'm saying we because we're connected all. This release had me kind of confused here. Nope, they're tapping surrender and release. Okay. I had to ask them again because I didn't know. Are they saying, because they hit the Virgo card too. And I'm like, are they saying release the Virgo? But they're not. They're not. But hey, just want true, real love, loyal, dedicated. Love, respect, adoration. I get this all the time. Divine timing. I know I've been pretty freaking patient, but in the laws of the universe, I guess sometimes I have. Oh, but they're telling them that they need to trust in the divine timing. Usually that's being told to me. What's assertion? Oh shoot. So assertion, and there they go back to the world card. Whenever they complete what they are going through, there's intensity, assertion, steadfast, perseverance. Ooh. Yeah, like, whoa. This is interesting. Right in the union, but it wasn't reverse. Is it supposed to be sitting in reverse? No. So it sounds like it's your twin flame. Of course, I mean, it's in where you guys are unified, hitting that Six of Swords in nature. I don't know, maybe y'all are gonna get away to some nature, you know? Maybe they're coming in to invite you to some nature. I don't know. You know, I gave a message of love despite all this shit. Because I'm staying at a cabin in Hawaii doing some work trades, some minor upgrades to this nice cabin, you know. And for me, for all of you that don't know, when I started this path of walking away from being a union carpenter and coming to Hawaii just to learn other materials to build with, starting with aircrete, so I could just build better life for myself and my community and teach people how to help themselves versus being attached to this capitalistic system where this system isn't working. And I'm not saying like just tear it all apart, but I came here and I mean, I've been stripped down to nothing, you know, homeless, you know, I've slept outside, you know, I've done work trade, I've had a lot of people help me out in other ways. I had scary nights, you know, sleeping outside in the rain, you know, no tarp, you know, but I had my rain gear, you know, in a hammock, you know, and the universe, I felt like had to strip me down, okay, so I would know, be reminded of what it is to not have and those that don't have and many other things. I'll go into it another time, but see, my mind's all over the place. Why was I? So what I did with this page of cups, bouncing back and forth, even though she didn't deserve it, and I extended, like, as my final, like, try with her, like, hey, I have this cabin for a month, which is a big deal for me, being homeless, okay? Because I'm just in the flow. I'm going where I'm told, onto the next, you know, work project. And I've been doing this for a little over a year. Invited, well, look at this retreat. Okay, I was laying over here. Where was I? What this one? It's saying both of you, yes, retreat. So I invited us to this cabin where, you know, we have a kitchen. Like, this is an undeveloped area. It's still Hawaii, but I'm on the Big Island and the part that's not so developed. And I'm in the jungle, not horribly far from town. But, you know, we've got a grill, or I have a grill there to use. I've got a gas stove, running water, shower. That when you do this work trade, it's not always easy to get the full shebang. I have the whole shebang, and I invited her to come heal with me, heal whatever this is, our friendship, you know, because we keep getting pulled back to each other. And you know, she just went all negative like she normally does. And I'm just like, enough is enough, you know? It's like she pops up and then you think, oh, she's gonna be cool now. And no, it's like just to tear you apart even more, you know? And you get a little bit more truth or a little bit more heart, but like a page. So I made that offer. Maybe some of you made an offer. I would say it was bigger than a little offer, but maybe some of you made that offer. I know that I just went off on a whole other thing, but I think it's kind of good. I know that I'm in this journey leading others by just shining the light behind me to say, yo, break left, break right, hey, this is what happened to me, you know, so people have, you know, easier go at this, to know that someone else is out here going through it too. And so I try to share as much as I can. So moving on, spirits, where are we going? We're going to the moonology. I think they're gonna wrap it up here. Whoa, already flipping. What do we got here? Whose side? Both your side, but who's more, and who, where does it rest? On your person's side. Confidence is the key to success. So it sounds like they want to come in, you know, like that Knight of Wands, but wouldn't it be nice if they're coming in like Empress and Emperor, you know, at least a king. But I don't know, some passion, I guess you gotta start somewhere, but I don't know. Divine timing, conclusions are within reach, they're saying on your person's side. What? Oh, hitting the union with this. The retreat. So just to recap for you guys, what you guys are unified here in the near future. We started off with nature, moving to calmer waters with the soulmate, okay, retreating and expecting a powerful change. Anything else? No knowledge. Whoa. Yeah. Their side again, okay. Is this back? Okay, where is this? Their side. Hold on, they're face down. Where is this going? Okay. So they are putting in some hard work. It says their hard work is paying off. Okay. Oh, okay. They got, what do you need to release? what? Oh. They need to release this defeat. You know, they might, you know, sometimes this defeat, you know, this could be just within themselves. It looks a bit personal within themselves. They didn't use my other deck, which the other deck is, you know, really someone trying to win at all costs, which is definitely what I've experienced. I don't know about y'all. But yeah, and they're confirming that. Okay. Where does this belong here? We want to clarify that a little bit more. What? Oh. What? Oh, not to worry. Oh, okay, where? Okay. So, nothing will come of this situation. It literally can mean nothing will come of the situation or not to worry. And they're saying not to worry. Okay. But what they're also saying is it's about them. They're in their head about making the first move. I'm sure they're not making the first move just right now. In what's going on, they're making the first move since y'all stopped talking. I'm sure many of you probably aren't even really talking. If you are, it's not copacetic. Yeah, no, they're saying they're in their thoughts about making that first move. But they're saying that you need to expect a powerful change for the union. Okay, what? Oh, okay. Bottom of the deck, they said your person is very close to achieving their goal. So interesting, because they're going so through it right now. I don't mean to laugh, but I'm saying I've been going through it, went through it. I'm sure a lot of you have gone through it too. All right, are we going to wrap it up? I feel the storm coming. Yeah, it says adjustments are required for that powerful change. And then they hit the Ace of Cups. So they got to come in and offer that cup of love for this change to happen. Is there anything else that we got to say? They're saying no. So, folks, we're going to leave it there. So much love. Mwah. Mwah, mwah. So many blessings. Please like, share, and subscribe. Help the channel grow. I appreciate you guys taking this time with me. And I look forward to sharing more. Oh, they told me. Hold on. Yeah, got it. Okay, got it. What? Oh. Got it. All right. Meditate and contemplate your person's side. So if there's cross watchers out here, cross watchers, meaning in the twin flame, you know, collective, it's kind of, I'm really, you know, reading for the person, you know. So it's like, oh, how do we have a cross watcher? Well, we have a cross watcher, someone that doesn't really believe in the twin flame journey, that's kind of spying in, though, because they believe a little bit, you know, or whatnot. But this person that's all in your thoughts and whatnot, if you're watching this, meditation and contemplation, and really just get out your head and offer this love that's busted through your heart chakra. Like, what's the hold up? What do you need to release? They're saying all the burdens of walking away. Oh, you scared that somebody's not gonna come back around? Just like they took the chances, you gotta take the chances too and find out. There's the balance. It's the karma. What goes around comes around. It's not really for us to sit here and play chess with the universe. That's when we fuck it all up. So, that being said, universe, do we want to leave it there? You said no. Okay. I got to talking too much, so maybe I... There's something else here they want to say. What do you want to say? We wrap this up. Okay. Where are we going with it? What? Which one? Oh, yeah? So they need to trust themselves and be confident. They said, they're just confirming what I just said. They hit the Ace of Cups with this. So confidence is their key to success. All right. Crosswatcher, confidence is your key to success. One way or another, the union has balance. Then you both can move on either together or apart. Together in nature to calmer waters, maybe some meeting ground with your soulmate. A soulmate. Then you guys get a retreat together and have a very, very powerful change. I love it. All right, I'm leaving it there. Peace, love, and blessings raining all over you guys. You take care.